Hello everyone, today I will show you how to create this really cool ripple animation effect. I'm not sure if you've seen anything like this before. From my experience, it's still not something I see being used on many websites. For this effect, I will be using just plain HTML and CSS so everybody can easily follow. I also want to say thank you for watching. Don't forget to like the video if you liked it, subscribe for more and click the bell icon so you get notified whenever I release a new video. So we will start with basic HTML markup, wrap everything up in a div with a class of container so we can center our buttons later. Always try to use semantic markup, especially in the production. Button tag is accessible by screen readers by default, and Google crawlers and other algorithms prefer these, so always try to use it over div with a class of button. Inside the button we will place 10 span elements to serve as our ripples and a p tag for label. Here I will create 4 buttons: home, about, products and contact. I like to start my CSS with basic reset rules so we don't get any unexpected behavior in different browsers. Now we center our container by giving it width, position relative and margin 70 pixels top bottom and auto on left and right. Since I'm using HTML5 button element, first I need to remove default styling, otherwise it will interfere with SVG filter I will be using later. And also let's give it some margin bottom, we will need space for the effect. So we have 10 span elements that will work as individual ripples. I will later blend them into to appear as a single element. Span is an inline element, so let's give it display block. That way it will accept width and height attributes. Also I need to center it along horizontal axis, so the usual trick: top 50%, transform translate 0, minus 50% and position absolute. This will work only if its parent, the button, also has position property declared. We want to increase the height of all span elements whenever we hover over a button. Since span is its child, we can use this syntax. I will actually need 11 span elements, so I need to add one more. I want the ripple effect to be even on both sides, so 5 on the left, 1 in the middle and 5 on the right. That will make our 6 span the middle element. Since we are using pure CSS, I cannot loop, so I will have to manually set transition delay and left position for all 11 spans. This will create ripples coming from the center of our button. I will speed this part up a bit so you can always pause the video if you struggle to keep up. Now we need to make our button text visible. I used p tag for this, so let's grab it. Let's make it white, 12 pixels and z index of 10. this will not work yet, as you can see, because z-index only works on positioned elements. So I'll give it position relative, and that should fix it. Transition 0.5 seconds and gray text color on hover. Now, the most important part that will create the liquid appearance. I will add a few SVG filters directly to our HTML markup and give it ID so I can point towards it with CSS. First filter will be blur with a value of 10. Then color matrix filter. This is quite complex and I won't be going into details how this works. All I will say, it gives us so many creative options, and I will include the link in the video description if you want to read the great explanation from someone who really understands it. And the last filter will be blend for overlaying elements. Now I use the filter on the main container div and point towards our custom filter with its ID. I called it goo. So let's do hashtag goo. The effect is applied, but it's very subtle. Let's make it more pronounced with tweak and color matrix values. 60 will work, but let's do 100 for a proper liquid feel. Now I want to make it bounce more, so I will add transition function to our transition property. You can go to the website cubicbezier.com and play with different settings. Sometimes you can use cubic bezier to replace keyframes if you're looking just for a simple pop or bounce effect. I see people using keyframes a lot, but it's not as flexible, as you cannot stop the animation in the middle, so it just skips blinks and jerks instead of animating if you leave hover state too early. You wouldn't have this problem if you used cubic bezier. And that's the effect. I will quickly scroll over the code files. If it isn't working for you, try to pause the video and compare the code. Thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to like the video if you liked it, subscribe, and click the bell icon. See you next time.